All right, so I just woke up a few minutes ago. There was a knock at the front door. First of all, you guys admiring my pink flowing monkey shorts? Anyway, back to the package. So this guy was just chilling outside and I was like, what is that? Then I looked at the other side and I was like, oh, that's what it is. So this company reached out to me a while back and they're like, dude, can we send you this? And I was like, dude, of course you could send that to me. They didn't tell me what they were sending or when they were going to send it, but I knew something was coming someday. You guys wanna know what's inside? Either way, if you continue watching, I'm gonna show you. It is the brand new Nutri Ninja Auto IQ Blender. Now, if you guys have watched my channel for any length of time, you know that I have mentioned these blenders in multiple videos. Anytime I do a day of eating video, show that protein recipe, make different kinds of dips or hummus, I've used Ninja. Anytime anyone's ever asked me, what blender do you use in your videos? What do you prefer? I say the Ninja Blender. If I got paid for every time I said that, I'd have a lot of blenders or a lot of money. But I just say it because I bought them myself and I think they're good. I think you should invest in a good blender. I don't know, it's just like everyone should have a good sharp knife. Anyway, I use the blender every single day. Actually, right here in the sink, there's the blender. Also have this one, good for making some smoothies and whatnot. But my ninjas decided to hook me up. This thing's packing 1500 watts and 2 horsepower. That's as much as a small lawnmower. Let's take a look inside. So, that's pretty cool. That came with a book. You wanna play with the blender? Yes, you do. You wanna blend stuff? Okay. All right, so it looks like we got the big boy here. 3 different cups. We got small, medium, and large. A food processor. And then we also have the base. Because it's all about that base. I didn't just say that. Wow, that is sexy. Frozen drinks and smoothies. We got puree, Ultra Ninja, Ultra Blend. And I'm probably going to have to read the manual to figure out how the hell this machine works. But that's everything right there. It looks like there's 3 cups for personal size smoothies, a huge blender, a food processor, and the base. All right, so not bad. Big shout out to my ninjas over at EuroPro for sending this out. I'm really excited to use this. I'll do a review if you guys are interested, but I make recipes all the time anyway, and people always ask what kind of blender that is, so I'll just always say it's a Ninja blender, but if you guys are actually interested in, I know it's gonna work well. I actually own three of them because I got one as a gift a while back from my brother because I'm a tool and I like kitchen stuff, but I'll talk about it, I'll show it in videos, and I'll let you guys know what I think of it, and that's it. So thanks again, Ninja, but let's start the video. Damn, my father is shredded. What's going on, everybody? So this was an after hours training session with my dad at my gym. Now, a lot of you guys know I've mentioned before that I do have a key to my gym. So when the gym is closed, I can go there after hours and train. Today was actually a Saturday around 6:30 p.m. when we hit the gym. The gym closes at 6. You'll notice in other clips there are people in the background. Those are other members who have been members for a long time and they have keys as well. And a couple of them are employees who choose to train after hours when their shift is over. So my intention was to go into the gym thinking it would be completely empty and get a raw training session with my dad. So just me, him, and the camera talking through the workout, interacting with you guys rather than doing a voiceover here. But that wasn't the case. But it's all good. We had a great training session and I was able to get some footage here. So my dad primarily went in to do some push work and hit some 70 pound dumbbells, which is, I guess, a PR for him. He's done 60s or 65s, but he struggles getting the weight into position and he's never had a spotter before. And that's simply because about 2 years ago, he had a shoulder surgery with a torn rotator cuff and biceps tendon. So it goes to show you, you know, injuries are setbacks, but that doesn't mean you can't overcome them. And he's a perfect example of someone who did. You know, he had to go through the recovery and the physical therapy and this and that and dealt with some muscle atrophy. So yes, his muscles did shrink and it took time to rebuild, but he just stayed positive through the whole thing, went through the therapy that was necessary in order to rehab himself. And I mean,
you don't really, actions speak louder than words. I don't need to say anything. Look at the shape he's in. At 57 years old, he looks better than me, and I'm 27 years old. And guys, I apologize for the delay, and I appreciate your patience. I've been saying for a while that I want to do an interview with him, talking about the steps that he took to get to where he is, everything that he's overcome, 100% raw, honest interview of his diet, training, supplementation, everything that he's done to hopefully inspire some people, regardless of how old you are. So I know people watching this channel are 15, and there are some people in their 50s, 60s, 40s, whatever the case is, you know, I think it would be great to share his transformation and his journey. So we'll be doing that. We've just been waiting for a time to where the gym was empty, because I just think it would be cool to do it in the gym setting after a training session. So I promise you guys that will be coming soon, and thank you so much for your patience. All right, so as far as my training goes, I was just focusing on deadlifts this day. And you guys know I have my program. I finished my 4 weeks of my microcycle. So next week I'll be starting the next phase of that. So I just went in there and wanted to crush some deadlifts. My last deadlift session just gave me trouble. I had 350 on the bar, and I was supposed to hit six sets of five, and I did, but they were sloppy in the first set. A couple of reps, I failed. I was having trouble getting the weight off the ground. I threw straps on, and things just didn't feel right. But today, for some reason, when I went into the gym, everything clicked. I had 365 on the bar. I was hitting sets of five, and there were a few sticking points, you know, sometimes off the ground, it didn't come up as fast as I wanted it to, but I managed to work up to a volume PR. My highest ever was 435 with straps when I went to visit Brandon Campbell and all them for the collab, and I've hit 405 for, I believe, two, and I only wanted to hit 405 for one after all this 365 volume, but I had my father there and I was ready to go. And I wish I could just play the raw clip, but I would probably get flagged for copyright because of the music in the background. But I'll let you hear what I say to my dad when he said, I think he said, are you going for two? And you'll hear me say, no, I'm just going for one. But I was in the zone. I was lifting the weight. So like I said, my intention was to hit one rep at 405 to see how it felt, but I was really happy with the speed of it. It was just, you know, a lot of people plan for their PRs and they go into the gym, and just because they said they were going to hit a PR that day, they go for it. And to me, when you're going for a PR, you hit that PR when you're ready to hit it. You don't, yes, you can plan for it, you can peak for it and do whatever you want to do, but there are just some days where you go into the gym and it's not there. The strength isn't there, the mindset isn't there, the focus isn't there. So in my opinion, that's not the right time to hit a PR, even if you scheduled yourself to hit it that day. And that's where it's important to understand your body. I knew I was feeling good, and I knew I was going to rip that 405 off the ground as fast as I could, whether it was one rep or two reps, regardless. But after that first rep, I told myself, just keep going. And I could have got more than five, but I just got worried, especially with my lower back. I was worried about form breakdown and I wasn't ready to risk injury. But needless to say, I was extremely happy with the, I guess that's a volume PR for me, the 405 for five, and knowing that I could pull more than that, both reps and weight. So feeling really good. Just kind of ended off the workout messing around with my dad. I was here curling 40s, and then he went ahead and went to curl the 40s, and of course I had to troll him in the background, and you'll see that in just a second. And we get along, you know, extremely well. We have a really good relationship together, and he's the reason that I'm able to communicate with people and just always stay so positive. So you'll see us laughing here, and this is how we are, you know, every time we hang out together. So always a good time with us too. I decided to end off my training with, well, I don't know why I even attempted this. I told myself at some point in my life I'd be able to do a muscle up, and I'll let you just watch me fail. And that's pretty much going to conclude the workout. I just decided to burn out some pull-ups, see how many I could do before leaving the gym. And that was the end of the workout, guys. So thank you very much for watching. I appreciate it as always. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, don't forget to click that thumbs up button, guys. I really appreciate that. And if you're looking for an online coach, information is in the description box below. You can email me, Matty@FusaroFitness.com, or you can visit the website, www.FusaroFitness.com. And big things to come, guys, I promise you. Thanks again. Love you all.
Cross it.